backyard.
No, it is wonderful. I think sometimes we take it for granted that we have something so wonderful like this, but in the summertime, this is a staple of Milwaukee, and where would we be if we did not have Summerfest?
Right now? Well, we'd be at the American Family Insurance Studio.
No, that's true.
That wouldn't be horrible. True. I mean, I also love it there.
That is factual.
But I like being outside. It's just so nice outside, y'all. And guess what? You can catch us live, so our shout out to our IT guy, John. Do we call him an IT guy? Is he IT?
Engineer.
Period engineering. But shout out to our engineer, John. He got us all tricked out over here in the best possible way. He got us set up, got us talking right, looking right, and he's got us up here with the camera. So yes, you can still stream us live on YouTube, on Twitter, on Twitch. Not only can you see Kyle and I here down here at the lakefront, but you can also still catch Benjamin in the booth. Ben, how you doing over there? We haven't even talked to you yet.
Amazing.
I'm done. Ben, I saw you earlier, and I almost said something to you like, see you at the festival, and then I realized I would not. But I was still happy that I saw your face. Are you having a good day, Ben?
It's all right. You know, I'm very, very happy today. It's a joyous day, and again, this is the first day of Summerfest. I mean, it's such an honor to be down. Well, I wish I was down there. All right, it's such an honor to see you guys down there enjoying yourselves. Eventually, I'll come down and catch those vibes, though.
Oh, absolutely. Well, we've got some friends that want to catch some vibes with us as well. We're very excited because we're going to be talking to a few different people today. Right now, though, we've got some friends from Associated Bank on the line that we're going to be chatting with. I believe we've got Tamara and Melissa. Tamara, Melissa, are you there?
Hi, I'm here. Tamara Castle.
Hello.
How you guys doing?
Hey, Tammy. Hey, Tam. Tam. How you doing? Tam? Is that you? Are you there? Or is that Melissa? Okay, we'll try to get them back in just a second here. But we are going to be talking to us. Oh. Are you there? All right, we'll figure it out. Ben, I can't tell if they are actually here. I hear their voices for like a second, and then it goes away. So you just let us know when they are ready to talk to us. But we are always ready to talk to y'all. Like I said, we're here at Summerfest. We're broadcasting live. And Kyle, we're fortunate because we're going to be here every Thursday and Friday.
Every single Thursday and Friday during the next 3 weekends of Summerfest, we have the opportunity to be able to broadcast live from Summerfest. And also, again, the Tory Lowe Show, we'll be coming to you live from Summerfest as well.
I was telling Kyle on our way in, I felt like I got the upgrade because this is the first time that I have been on a show where we're doing the live broadcast. So I've always been fortunate to be a part of the Pop Culture Report, of course, on the Tory Lowe Show. And he's done Summerfest every year that 101.7 The Truth has been in Milwaukee. However, this is my first time actually being a part of a show where I'm like here every single day. And we get to be the show that starts off the day at Summerfest. So I feel really fortunate to be here, Kyle. I'm serious. Like, I really walked in here like, okay, it's giving upgrade, and I'm here for it.
We get to kick it off. All eyes are on us.
See, the thing is, you're a football guy, so you say kick it off. I'm a basketball gal, so I say tip off.
That's
you know what I mean?
But
either way, you know what I mean? It still rings true. I believe that the ladies are back. Tamara, Melissa, are you there?
Yes, good afternoon.
Hello. Hi, there they are. Hi, ladies. Oh, we are doing so well.
How are you guys
doing? Hi.
Good.
Oh, it's so good to hear you. Okay, so
nice to Summerfest. Can you hear us?
I know. Oh, I can hear you. I can hear you. So real quick, ladies, before we get into our discussion, I just want to formally introduce you to our listeners. So we've got Tamara Castle. She's the loan officer at Associated Bank, and then Melissa Blount is the senior vice president, director of multicultural and affordable lending. Ladies, how are you doing on this beautiful Thursday?
Oh, wonderful. Very blessed. Thank you for having us.
Yes, of course. We are so
I
happy
can't wait to
have
get
you
over
here with you
summer
today. I know you need to. Okay, I'm not even kidding, ladies.
We're having so much fun.
It is. Perfect. I'm telling you, perfect outside. Because, you know, usually by the lake, it's a little bit cooler, but it's so, like, it's hot out today and it's really sunny. So I feel like being down by the lake is exactly where you want to be on a day like today.
Can't wait.
Well, ladies, I'm excited that you are on the line here. First off, we very much appreciate our partnership with Associated Bank. We've been working with you ever since our inception, and it has just been such a joy. We learn a lot, and I always am so intrigued by the different, I guess, financial literacy educations that you have given me, and not only myself, but also our listeners. And today, we, of course, are going to continue that education. Ladies, we have a lot of things that we want to discuss with you, okay? And I know that it's Home Ownership Month. I want to know, why is Associated Bank a proponent on increasing home ownership in the Black community? Why do you think it's so important?
That is a great question. Thanks for asking. It, as a part of the community, Associated Bank, we want to make sure that we provide home ownership opportunities for everybody in it. But more importantly, like you asked, why is it important for the Black community? It is because home ownership rates, number one, are the lowest in the country. Blacks across the country have a lower home ownership rate than whites, than Asians, than Hispanics. And this is one of the primary ways that we as a community build generational wealth. So if this big asset is not a part of our financial toolkit, we are crippled as far as our wealth building opportunities. It's how people have funded sending their kids off to college, preparing for retirement, how to launch the next generation in home ownership. People have used the equity in their homes to do things like that. Without having a home, you don't have that equity to tap into to be able to do those other things to increase your generational wealth for that of you and your family and your children, and so on.
That's wonderful to talk about, and I'm glad you brought up a lot of those great statistics when it comes to home ownership and really the lack thereof and why we need to be able to increase that here in Milwaukee. So I am a big proponent, as Mel said, just as a big proponent as Associated Bank is. And so can we just talk about what are some of the benefits and why we always preach home ownership? Hello, you there?
Okay, so No, I thought Tamara was going to take this one. I'm sorry, I'm here.
I was disconnected. Okay. I'm here. A lot of benefits to home ownership. And when we do our classes, we focus on a lot of things. But I always point out, you know, for instance, having credits for repairs, right? So I give an example of even just this morning, my plumber came and replaced one of my water heaters. And I know that I can make that as a credit on my taxes next year. You can't really do that if you don't own the property. So that's one of the benefits. The other one that's really prominent in the community is stability. And it may sound simple, but it's very important for families. You know, it gets to the point where you don't have to worry about that your landlord is going to sell the house or they're going to move somebody else in and you got 30 days to get out. You're stable in your property. I give an example of just your kid's bus stop. Your kid's bus stop is the same bus stop. You know what I mean? And the kids are familiar with the neighbors and it really brings you together. I know my neighbors for 18 years. We watch out for each other. So a lot of that, stability is very important. And then we talked about the generational wealth and me having this duplex that I bought 18 years ago. When I buy my next property, which will be bigger for my grandkids, my two children, this house is for them. One unit for each. Yeah. They can stay there. Yeah. They can rent it out themselves or they can sell it. It's up to them. And then they can pass it on to my grandkids. So it's so important for me and the community to have an asset like that to continue the generational wealth, especially in the Black community.
And when you talk about that hits home because my grandparents actually had a property that they rented out and something that my father, it was instilled in my father and instilled in my aunts and uncles. So that's something that they did. And so that now is a family tradition that we're going to have three generations of family being able to continue to do something like that. And hopefully when I have children, my brother have children, my cousins do, they can continue this piece of this asset that we have to provide great living for our community while also being able to provide this generational wealth for our family. So that's something that I think is tremendous.
Yeah, Absolutely.
Lady, you know, I was talking
I was talking with another colleague of mine, and one of the strategies that she and her family have done is they've worked hard to buy a house specifically for each of their children before they reach the age of 10. And they've used one asset to buy the next, but those assets are is how they're going to pay for them to go to college. Right? So they're using this investment today to help what the children will need for tomorrow. It's an asset. They can live in it and go to school, or they can rent it out and have money coming in to pay for school. They can sell it. They can lease it. It's an asset to help them with their education. And I thought that was amazing. So that's how they're building their family portfolio, like you were just talking about.
That's wonderful, ladies. It's all about generational wealth, and, you know, obviously that's a really big thing in the Black community, being able to generate that and, like you said, create a better future for our offsprings and beyond. So I have a question for you, but I'm going to make it a twofold. What advice would you give to a prospective home buyer, and can you talk about the products that Associated Bank has to offer for first-time home buyers?
So when I talk to my customers that come in and when I talk to customers that come in, they're looking to purchase, one of the more important things is gathering documentation and knowing where that documentation is. For instance, your tax returns, W-2s, pay stubs, things that we kind of gather. We might shred it, or we don't, you know, look at it every day. But those are very important documents we need in order to get you pre-approved to purchase that home and get approved for the mortgage loan. Connecting with a local trustworthy lender like myself at Associated Bank is also important for prospective home buyers. You want to make sure that you work with someone that you can trust, because once again, we're talking about some very personal information, right? And it can be scary. So you want to make sure that you're talking to someone that's trustworthy and that's in the community. Also practicing focus and patience, because you have to trust the process. It's not short. It can be long. But when you're working with these, our professionals like myself, we will guide you through it, and you have to trust the process. So I tell that to every single person that walks in the branch or calls me and says, you know, I'm looking to purchase a home. We start talking about that and make sure to gain that trust of the customer, because it's going to get detailed, and, you know, it's very detailed, and there's a lot of information. So you want to make sure you're working with a trustworthy bank. Now, at Associated Bank, we do have all the general products, you know, with conventional, FHA, VA, but we also have a special in-house product that is just for Associated Bank customers, and it's called CARE. And our CARE product is, again, for first-time or second-time home buyers, and it's based off of a little bit more lenient than other products. So, for instance, single-family would be 3% down, duplex 5% down. We accept non-traditional credit, which, you know, a lot of banks do that. We accept non-traditional, meaning I may not have a lot of things on my credit report, like credit cards and loans, but I do pay my bills, and they're on time. So I say, you know, you pay your rent on time, line of credit. Do you pay your car insurance, your cable, your internet? We go as far as Hulu, Netflix, and Amazon. You know, almost everybody has that, right? I have too many streamings. And we use that as non-traditional credit and follow, like, have you been on time? Is it coming out your bank account? And we can use that as credit, because now a lot of people have 5, 10 credit cards, right? You might be starting fresh. We can still assist you with our in-house product. We will work with the customer, make sure we gather the documents, make sure they're paying those bills on time, and we can use that as a line. The other special thing about Associated Bank is we actually have funds. So just for our customers, our money, it comes straight from our CAO. They put money to the side, and it's called PATH. It's a gift, and it's up to $5,000 to help with the down payment and closing costs. Now, that is extremely important, because one of the things that's lacking in our community is the savings, and Associated Bank is here to assist with that.
I mean, when you just said that, sis, and I want to wrap up here, and again, we are speaking to Tamira Castle, loan officer at Associated Bank, and Melissa Blunt, SVP and director of multicultural and affordable lending at Associated Bank. And you kind of just talked on about this, but I just want to let people know is that how can they reach out to you, and how big of a resource will Associated Bank be when it comes to walking people through the step? Because this can be a process that is very scary, and it's hard to take the first step. How can people reach out to Associated Bank, and can they trust that Associated Bank is going to help them every step of the way through that process?
Absolutely. We have a number of loan officers that specialize in helping first-time home buyers. One of the things that we tell people, you know, you gotta do it. You just gotta do it, right? So that Nike slogan, just do it. You need to start your vision board, right? When you think you're starting to think about the process, start going on tours, walk through homes, look at the process, do your research. So when you meet with that trusted advisor here at Associated Bank, part of my team, like Tamara, you will already have known, you know, what documents you need to bring, what questions you want to ask, what you want to look for as far as a home, what kind of perk, what side of town. All of those things are a part of kind of your homework, your vision board session, so that you can start this. It is very scary, but it's something that we need to embrace, but also teach our children to embrace, right? So take them on the journey with you as you're doing your budgeting and your research and your homework, so that when it's time for them to purchase, they're all ready for it. So I'll turn it to Tamara to add on to that.
You can walk into any Associated Bank branch and mention Tamara Castle. They'll route you straight to me. I'm also constantly in the community. I'm doing housing fairs. This weekend especially, Sherman Park is having a housing fair. I'll be on a panel. We're going to be tabling with Associated Bank at Boys and Girls Club from 9 to 12. We'll be there. And again, using somebody like me, I understand what they're going through. I understand the perspective of the customer. It's not easy. It's difficult. They can reach out to me through email, fax, however it's more comfortable. Some people are not comfortable with technology, so I can meet them at the branch and help them with that. I make sure that I'm out there as much as possible, but at the same time, they can always walk into any of our local Associated Bank branches and ask for Tamara Castle, and I'll be there to assist them.
Ladies, thank you so much.
At Associated Bank.
Tamara.Castle at Associated Bank. Ladies, thank you so much. I really wish we could keep talking to you. But that was Tamara Castle, loan officer, and Melissa Blount, Senior Vice President, Director of Multicultural and Affordable Lending at Associated Bank. They know opportunity cannot wait. If you're a female or minority small business owner, their community uplift loans could be for you. Their loans range from $5,000 to $50,000, and you get your funds in as little as one business day. So talk to a relationship manager today about a community uplift loan and other business banking services. Again, that's Tamara.Castle at AssociatedBank.com. You can also call them 800-270-7725. Visit AssociatedBank.com or stop by your local branch. We'll be right back, y'all.
More of Nothing But the Truth with Melanie Ricks, live from Summerfest, the world's largest music festival, on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Marvel's The Black Panther is coming to the Bradley Symphony Center Friday, June 23rd through Sunday, June 25th, and now you can experience one of the most critically acclaimed superhero films of all time through a live music performance by the Milwaukee Symphony Orchestra. And to celebrate this incredible show, The Truth and the Milwaukee Symphony Orchestra are now offering a special 15% discount just for you. Visit MSO.org right now and enter promo code PANTHER. That's MSO.org and enter promo code PANTHER to receive your seats today.
This is your ACTS Housing Home Buying Tip of the Week with D. Kemp. D, what are some of the barriers to home ownership?
Everyone's journey to home ownership is different, and we all have different challenges. For some people, it's that they don't have any credit. For some people, it's that they need to do some credit repair. For others, it's the challenge of saving at the same time as you're attempting to keep up with your monthly bills on a regular basis. So it really is about developing the habits and behaviors necessary to achieve home ownership. And that's one of the key things we do at Axe Housing, is provide that home buyer education so you're ready and prepared not just to purchase your home, but to keep your home over the long term and use it as a mechanism to start building wealth. It's so easy to get started on this journey. All you need to do is go to axehousing.org, complete our virtual orientation, and get yourself started on your journey to home ownership.
Are you looking for an opportunity to better the Milwaukee community? Do you want to develop your skills for a career or job? City of Milwaukee is recruiting for its 14th cohort of AmeriCorps members. We are hiring young adults ages 18 to 25 to serve our amazing scholars in Milwaukee Public Schools. This opportunity allows you to serve your community and gain professional development, which will allow you to enter the workforce, your next educational journey, or even stay with us for a second year of service. Visit cityyear.org to connect with our local recruiters and learn how to apply.
Locked Inside Every Wisconsinite is a unique code shaped by genetics, environment, and lifestyle. This code makes you uniquely you and holds clues to your predisposition to certain illnesses like diabetes, cancer, or depression. When you join the All of Us Research Program, you help researchers study ways to improve healthcare and receive health information that matters to you. Learn more. Visit allofus.wis.edu or call 888-294-2661. Answers are in All of Us.
This is 1017 The Truth, Sherwin Hughes, and I Am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community, and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 1017 The Truth.
I think they both were like, no, you go. Nick, can you hear me?
You are listening to Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks, live from Summerfest, the world's largest music festival, on 1017 The Truth. At 1017thetruth.com.
Mel has money in the bank, and you can too when you join Associated Bank. But you know what? We're at Milwaukee's biggest party on the lake. And guess what? Not only are we celebrating Summerfest, we are celebrating Summerfest with you by giving you a hookup. So right now is your chance to win a pair of tickets to see A Boogie with the Hoodie and City Girls live at the American Family Insurance Amphitheater right here at Summerfest. Call 833-212-1017 and be caller number 5. Be caller number 5 at 833-212-1017 to win tickets to see A Boogie with the Hoodie and City Girls live at the American Family Insurance Amphitheater here at Summerfest. 833-212-1017. Call number 5. Have fun with the phones, Ben.
Yeah, I was going to say, because yesterday, first of all, Ben, I hope you know Kyle's doing you real dirty.
Big stress.
Because you know, should have said call like 15. No, those lines lit.
Well, I said call number 5, so, because what happens is when you do, because this is what Tori do. If Tori would say call number 10, which he going to get more than 10 calls, but then people keep calling and calling and calling and calling and calling and just keep ringing and ringing.
See, and I keep it 100. I keep it 1017, Kyle. Once I see us get up to like line 12, I'm like, all right, y'all, we gotta win it. Just stop calling. You know, because I will.
Our friend Tori did not do that. Tori loves being the phone.
He loves it.
He got that slow right now.
I'm done.
He got that fire.
I'm done. I was going to say, he's like, hey.
Y'all going to have to call back.
Hey. I cannot. Short story. Wait, this is cute. Tell me why I made a post on IG just saying, like, we're here, come say hi and all that.
Jean commented,
and she goes, Sarah wants to know if Zach is going to be there with you at all. And I thought that was so cute.
We'll be joining us shortly. Get your Saturday going right and end your Saturday right on July 6th. Start it on Saturday right and end it right on July 6th, Saturday.
Love that. I cannot believe that it's almost July. Like, I was planning something with one of my friends, and she was like, yeah, like, one of my girlfriends, she asked me to go with her to, or go to her dad's birthday party, and it's Chicago. I'm like a family friend, Kyle, so don't worry about me. But she was like, it's on July 2nd. I'm like, July 2nd? That's next weekend.
It sure is.
How is that next weekend?
June's all, the greatest month is almost over.
I think the greatest month will be here in about a month or so. It's giving
too,
August.
It's too hot in August.
I love
Nobody
August.
Nobody got time for all that.
But this is the thing, Kyle. It's so cold here that August is like our prime. August is like the, we're not in Wisconsin anymore month. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no.
This is very Wisconsin here 9 months out of the year.
And my allergies get messed up in August, too.
Your allergies do? I actually was thinking about this today because my dog, Paul, he has bad allergies as well. And he and I, we tend to have flare-ups of the same
dog. Dogs is like humans, bro. I tell you.
And how many allergies, times do I have to tell you my dogs are humans?
I got knee surgery.
I'm telling you, Kyle. My dogs are humans.
They taking Ozempic.
Listen, I'm telling you. You said Ozempic.
Ozempic for dogs. He's trying to lose weight.
It's giving. You know what? Low-key, Mabel could use that. I'm bogus for that. Yeah. Mabel, I love you, honey. But Paul, I was thinking about this today, actually, so it's funny you said allergies. I think it's a transitional thing. Like, I think when the weather or when the seasons change, because that's when my allergies get really bad.
Yeah.
Because now mine are fine. They're calmed down. Yeah. And I think it's because we're going from quote-unquote spring, to I say summer, that in quotes because it's not real
or
spring,
whatever it was,
you know, yeah, into summer. Yeah. You know what I mean? Does that make sense to you?
No, that makes sense. I don't be outside enough. When I used to play football, August used to be terrible. That's when my allergies were backed up because being in the grass.
Yeah.
And I'm allergic to ragweed.
Oh, that sucks. Yeah. I feel like ragweed is everywhere.
That's what they say on the thing.
Yeah.
That's what my doctor told me.
Yeah. See, I have allergy-induced asthma, but they have never been able to tell me what I'm allergic to. Like, I'm just allergic to the environment because the only actual allergy that I have is penicillin. However, I do have, I developed asthma around the age like 26. And the reason why I found out is because I had an asthma attack. And I didn't know what it was, dog. It was so scary. I had an asthma attack. I didn't know what it was. I couldn't breathe. I went to urgent care. They're like, yeah, we need to take x-rays. And it came back and they're like, yeah, so we think that you have allergy-induced asthma. And I'm like, first off, I don't even have allergies. Second of all, who gets asthma when they're 26? But apparently it's more common than you realize.
No, it definitely is where people develop that. With older age.
Yeah, it's very, very crazy. We are going to be talking to our friends over at Cousin Subs here in just a second, but I want to give a shout out to Stephanie. Congratulations. She's going home with those A Boogie with the Hoodie and City Girls tickets. Steph, if you need somebody to go with you, I'm your girl. Hit me up, 833-212-1017. And make sure y'all stay locked. And you can tune in live. Kyle and I are here down at Summerfest. We're down at the biggest party on the lake, world's largest music festival. And, of course, you can catch Ben Jammin back in the producer booth. But coming up next, we've got Justin McCoy. He's a VP of marketing over at Cousin Subs. I'll work on that. And we're going to work on some things in just a second. Make sure y'all stay locked.
This is Nothing But the Truth with Melanie Ricks, live from Summerfest, the world's largest music festival on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
From my family and myself, I would like to say thank you to Gruber Law Offices for taking such good care of us.
I would say thank you because you're so human and so much of a friend during the whole process.
I'm super grateful for them representing me and doing all that they did for me.
I would just say thank you for making me feel better.
That's why I'm here, to say thank you, thank you, thank you.
Gruber Law Offices, one call, that's all. keeping you informed and up to date on the legislation which will impact you the most.
So right now, we do not have the two-thirds vote necessary to pass the sales tax increase for Milwaukee. If it does pass, we are still in deep financial trouble, and we have all of these strings attached to this legislation. So like I did yesterday, I'm going to do again today and tomorrow until the cows come home. I want you to call your Milwaukee Common Council member and tell them that you are not in favor of this proposal that has far too many negative strings attached to Milwaukee. That includes a sales tax increase that doesn't even get us out of debt. In fact, if they vote for this, we will have to go back to this same Republican-controlled legislature and ask for more money, and then the strings will be even more severe than they are right now. This thing cannot pass. It cannot.
Stream the award-winning 101.7 The Truth every day by downloading the Truth app and on all your favorite streaming platforms.
They are our cuddlers and coworkers, purr machines and love bugs, and constant companions. They are our pets, our family, and they make life so much better. When we face unexpected challenges in life, so do our pets. That's why we're on a mission to support people who love their pets and the pets who love their people, ensuring these families stay exactly where they belong, together. And you have something to offer. With an open heart and mind, there is nothing you can't do. There's no gesture too small or too big when it comes to helping. Whether donating a bag of kibble, sharing an Instagram post of a lost cat, or welcoming a foster pet into your home, every bit of kindness counts. You can help keep pets and people together. Visit petsandpeopletogether.org to learn how to be a helper in your community. This has been a public service announcement brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Greg Matzik. Draft night in the NBA, the Bucks own just one selection, number 58 overall. It's the final pick in tonight's two-round event. Local product, Brandon Podziemski, invited to the green room where he's expected to be a first-round pick. Podziemski was a standout at St. John's Northwestern Academy in Delafield before starring at Santa Clara. And Aaron Rodgers is in Denver speaking at a psychedelics convention.
You know, previous year, 26 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. We had a good season. Ayahuasca, 48 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. MVP.
And the Brewers begin a 10-game road trip Friday night in Cleveland against the Guardians. This sports update presented by Associated Bank. Proudly supporting our hometown teams. Member FDIC.
More of Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks, live from Summerfest, the world's largest music festival, on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You wanted more than just a house. You wanted a place where your kids would feel totally protected, be free to dream of what's possible, explore their passions, and maybe even follow in your footsteps. And nobody understands that more than American Family Insurance. That's why they help protect the dreams of the next generation. And now you can save up to 23% when you bundle home and auto. Get a quote, find an agent, and learn about their discounts by going to AmFam.com. Also, I've shared it with you before, LabCorp Clinical Trials is becoming Fortrea Clinical Trials, F-O-R-T-R-E-A ClinicalTrials.com. Same great people, same great location, over 40 years in business. They've got a new website, again, that's FortreaClinicalTrials.com, and they remain committed to bringing you the same great experience, professionalism, and new opportunities under the new Fortrea name. Make sure you go to FortreaClinicalTrials.com right now to learn how you can help them advance medicine while making money at home. And right now, oh my goodness.
Wait.
Oh, you couldn't wait.
Oh, he dug it. He's already in it.
Kyle is hilarious. Okay, so we need a live reaction. So first off, let's introduce our guest. We're here with Justin McCoy from Cousin Subs. How are you, Justin?
I'm doing great. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. I'm really excited to be here with you.
I'm excited to be here.
I'm very pumped to be here with you. So Kyle, can you talk about, okay, well actually, let me say it because you're
You gotta say it. Listen, it's y'all interview. I'm just here to add on. I'm ad-libbing. Y'all just gonna listen to me eat this delicious Cheeto sub. hot Cheeto sub that we have here from Cousin Sub.
So let me say exactly. So it's a Cheetos Flamin' Hot Cheese Steak Sub.
Yes,
this is intense.
It's intense. It's a lot of food.
Okay, Justin. Okay, I got to hear a lot. Okay. All right. So, Justin, where did this creation come from?
Well, so we've been partners with Summerfest 4 years. We've actually been down here for 49 years. And over the last several years, they've always asked us if we can come up with a special sub for the fest.
Okay.
And so this year, our director of operations and one of our area directors came up with this. So Ron and Hillary came to us and said, we got an idea with the Flamin' Hot, Flamin' Hot Cheetos.
Yeah.
And we put it together. So it's a double portion of steak, lettuce, onion, cheddar cheese slices,
okay,
Wisconsin cheddar cheese sauce,
okay,
hot sauce, and Flamin' Hot Cheetos.
That double portion of steak, double the meat. I go to Cousin Sub, I ask for double the meat. This is a double portion. This is delicious.
It's the real deal.
I'm speechless hearing that. That's incredible. Okay, so how do you come up with this confection? Like, how do you figure out what's going to work together?
It's all experimentation. We have a restaurant in our office,
okay,
and we actually do all of our menu development and creation in there.
We go
in the lab and we just start putting stuff together.
Best job ever, by the way.
It's super
fun. Tester. Oh yeah. Gosh, do I have to try another sub today? I guess.
Yeah, it's just
I
horrible.
Love it. That's awesome. Okay, so Kyle, would love to hear your live review.
It's delicious. So I'm already a big fan of Cousin Subs.
Yeah.
And as we already know, being from Milwaukee, born and raised, Milwaukee Black Talk Radio, Cousin Subs has been a staple in Milwaukee for many, 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 many years, especially in the neighborhoods that are black communities. I actually go to the one on 76th Street in Good Hope, 76th in Good Hope. Been going there for many, many years. So I've been getting cheesesteak forever.
Yeah.
I don't like adding too much stuff on.
Right.
The hot flaming Cheetos on it, they taste good, especially
really?
If you like hot flaming Cheetos. Mm. It adds a different little kick spice to it. On top of that, with the melted cheese that they have on here as well.
And it's got the crunch.
Cheetos. It adds two things, especially if you like hot flaming Cheetos. It adds two things that you definitely will love. And, of course, that brand of Cousin Subs. No, it really is good, and I suggest everybody come down and try it. And I know for a fact that you all have a place set up here at Summerfest as well.
Yeah, we're right over by the Miller Lite Oasis, so you can come down and get the sub. We're doing it exclusively here, too, by the way. It's not in stores.
So they have to come here.
They got to come here to try it.
Okay, and then also, so I just tried your cherry lime shake. This is delicious. I don't remember the last time I had a shake.
Yeah, so cherry lime shake is special in the stores right now, and then we also always have a vanilla, chocolate, and a strawberry shake.
Yummy.
And that's actually a gelato, so that's why it's nice and creamy. It's not grainy.
It's
so good.
So good.
And it's nice to cool off after a Flamin' Hot Cheetos.
Perfect. It's perfect pairing, if you will.
Yeah.
So I have to talk about this incredible shirt that you have on. As soon as Justin approached, I asked him about it. And you're dropping you actually started a new merchandise line. Is it officially live?
It is officially live. So CousinsSubsShop.com. You can go and get your favorite Cousin Subs merchandise swag.
Nice.
We designed this shirt for the fest, and they can go on and get that t-shirt. It went live this morning. And then we also brought you a bobblehead today. We just put up the bobblehead, and we have hats. We have all sorts of other merchandise, too. So that's our mascot, Subby.
Aw, Subby. He's adorable. I love that this has, like, kind of a retro vintage, acid wash look. I like that a lot.
Yep, that's what we were going for. We thought it would be great for Summerfest anniversary. Thought it would be a great fit.
It's perfect. Okay, so does the taste test team, are they the same ones that develop your merchandise, or how does that work?
Well, I run menu development, and I help create the merchandise, but there's a team behind me
that
works on all that. So there's a collective. We have operations involved, training involved.
For sure.
Some of our teammates that are out here, get involved in all that too. So
that's wonderful. So if people come down, they try this incredible new sub, can they also purchase the merchandise here?
So we're not selling the merchandise here, but if they just go to the website, they can purchase all the stuff that we have, and we'll be doing stuff seasonally and stuff too, over time. But we just launched it. Really excited about it. It's getting rave reviews so far.
That's really great. I mean, I love it. I'm going to put my shirt on because I appreciate you bringing me one. Thank you so much, Justin.
If they're on YouTube, they can definitely take a look and see at 1017thetruth.com, 1017thetruth on YouTube. You can definitely see these awesome shirts that you can get at Cousin Subs. That's Cousins with the S, Subs with the S, and shop.com.
Absolutely. Okay, so Justin, I got to ask you then something a little bit off. What's your favorite thing about Summerfest? Like, why do you enjoy coming down here? Because when we sat down together, the first thing we kind of talked about was how nice it is outside and just how nice it is to be by the lake. What's your favorite part?
Food, actually.
Okay.
I actually love coming down during the day, walking around, just trying food all day. Love the music as well,
yes,
but just being on the lakefront, I used to live downtown. I don't live downtown anymore, so it's a great opportunity for me to come down here and enjoy what I used to do when I was in my 20s. The food is probably one of my favorite things, is just walking around during the day, live music, trying all the different types of food.
For sure, absolutely. Well, we're very excited to be here with you and appreciative to be here. And, of course, thank you again. I'm going to try my sub. I don't want to try it right now because I'm talking. I don't want to be like Kyle.
I couldn't wait. I'm hungry. 12:30.
I know you couldn't wait.
When they walk by, I did not know who they – I'm not even going to lie because, we see people walk by. by.
Yeah.
So I saw people walk by with Cousin Subs in their hands, and I yelled, Cousin Subs. I love Cousin Subs.
I know you do.
Well, he handled it pretty well, taking a bite.
Yeah, he really did.
No, I'm a professional, and those looking to fuel up during the 9-day festival here at Summerfest can find Cousin Subs concessions located across from the Miller Lite Oasis stage, correct?
Absolutely.
And that's exactly where you can get this Cheetos Flamin' Hot Cheese Steak that I just ate and that you can see. If you go to our social media page, you'll be able to see Maya taking great pictures. If you go on our YouTube, you can see this beautiful sandwich in front of you. And that is your opportunity to come down to Summerfest to try this great Cheetos Flamin' Hot Cheese Steak.
Yeah, and we'll have your other favorites, too. We have ham and provolone, turkey, club, Italian special. We're doing the normal cheesesteak. We got fries, Wisconsin cheese curds. And then we're also doing special cheese fries, too. That cheese sauce that's on there, we're doing cheese fries over at the stand, too.
Okay, Justin, my mouth is watering. I get it. You've got some.
Now, Justin, I want you to tell the people working Summerfest when they see Kyle, the black dude with dreads. Now, that's what I tell people. And I come down there, they're going to have to plug me with the extra double the portion of meat on this, okay?
All right, we can make it happen.
All right, now.
Isn't it already double?
I like more.
Oh, okay.
I want more.
It's quadruple.
I'm trying to get big.
I
got to get ready for the winter. It's the summertime. I got to get husky for the wintertime.
You're bulking.
I am. Thank you. Exactly.
He's crazy. It's always bulk season. Really appreciate you, Justin. Anything else you want our listeners to know?
No, we're looking forward to seeing you throughout Summerfest, and hope everyone has a great time and enjoys this great Milwaukee staple.
Absolutely. We are so fortunate to be here again. Make sure you come and try their Summerfest exclusive Cheetos Flamin' Hot Cheese Steak Sub. Come try this cherry lime shake. And, of course, you can go to CousinSubShop.com. Again, that's CousinSubShop.com. Go and grab your merchandise and their subby bobblehead, which is so adorable. I'm literally obsessed with him, and I have a bobblehead collection. So thank you so much. I appreciate that. We'll be back with more. Make sure you come on down. It's the biggest party on the lake, and we are broadcasting live.
More of Nothing But the Truth with Melanie Ricks, live from Summerfest, the world's largest music festival, on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
This is Telly Hughes from Truth Be Told, and I surprised my wife on her birthday with a staycation at the beautiful St. Kate the Arts Hotel in downtown Milwaukee last weekend, and it was an incredible experience. And check this out. I enjoyed my experience so much that I want to offer our Truth fans a chance to experience this second-to-none hotel completely free. Tune into Truth Be Told from 7 to 9 all week as I will be entering fans in to win a free staycation at the St. Kate Hotel.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Melanie Ricks, and I am Milwaukee. I love Milwaukee so much. I love how rich this city is in history, and I love how rich we are in the moment. I think that every day there's something new that our city accomplishes, but it's important that we keep remembering that it takes a village to be great, and I know that we can be great as long as we all stick together. So why not stick together and join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations, where you can speak your truth? We are the new 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community, and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations, where you can speak your truth. We are the new 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
All your favorite interviews and best moments live in one place.
You know, I'm working in the morning, and I was listening back on the Truth app.
Download the new 101.7 The Truth app now. Milwaukee Black Talk. 101.7 The Truth. Bringing all the smoke to you.
I love what you're doing, and this radio station is just like what it's called. It's the truth.
Download the new 101.7 The Truth app now. Milwaukee Black Talk. 101.7 The Truth.
This is your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute.
Justice is about receiving what we deserve. Quote Audre Lorde, who said, "There is no such thing as a single issue struggle because we do not live single issue lives." And that said, any freedom, including reproductive freedom, is our human right to decide what is best for our own lives. Reproductive freedom is about having bodily autonomy, which is the same as being able to control what happens to our bodies, including the decision to continue or terminate a pregnancy, rests with the pregnant person at all times and in all circumstances. Because when rights don't apply to all individuals and at all times, they are not rights. They are not rights. And as Black people, our rights are conditional way too often, whether we're talking about during police encounters, quality housing, or, you know, some job opportunity.
This has been your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute on the new 101.7 The Truth. You are listening to Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks, live from Summerfest, the world's largest music festival, on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. It's better than yours, I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. It's better than yours, I could teach you, but I have to charge.
I know you want it, the thing that makes me,
what the guys go crazy for.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Okay, Ben, you are hilarious.
They lose their minds.
Okay, no, Kyle, this is my moment. No, I'm just kidding. Hey, Hannah girl.
I thought you were talking about me because of my milkshake.
Okay, no, Kyle, we're talking about my milkshake, sorry. this is my cherry lime milkshake that's bringing the boys to the yard, Kyle.
Oh, that's the
Thank
milkshake
you.
We're talking about.
Oh, yeah, that was like... He's so great.
My bad.
Oh, my gosh. All right. Are you guys tired of paying rent to a landlord and not yourself? Do you want some freedom from paying that rent? And are you ready to build your own equity? Well, team up with Axe Housing. They can absolutely make it possible for you. They've already helped over 3,000 families buy their own home. You can be next. Get started on your own virtual orientation because they've got coaches that are ready to help you find the best path to home ownership. There are no restrictions on who can access the program. All you got to do is go to axehousing.org. And they're looking for some general contractors to work on houses. They'll need 100 by the end of the year. So if you're a contractor, you're looking for some great work, check out axehousing.org right now. And I mentioned this to you earlier, and I got to say it again. We are so pleased to share with you that Labcorp Clinical Trials is now Fortrea Clinical Trials. Fortrea ClinicalTrials.com. Fortrea ClinicalTrials.com. They've got studies for healthy adults, and they've got some great ways for you to help them advance medicine while making money right at home. Make sure you go to FortreaClinicalTrials.com to learn more.
We're getting spoiled over here, Mel. God.
We really are. It's actually like, okay, I get it. This is only day one, two. Like, Jason, are you kidding me? We outside. Look at all of this. I mean, we out here. I love it. Thank you so much. They got me some nice fried cheese curds. That was so sweet of them. We got Cousin Subs over here. We're drinking our milkshakes, our cherry lime shakes, to be exact. It's giving hashtag blessed. Like, are you kidding me, Kyle? What a great day of work.
He's giving hashtag, really, my working? Diet is over.
Are we working right now? Like, what is this? Oh, I'm going to the gym after this, best believe. But that's okay. We're not going to worry about that right now.
I ate bread all week.
I know. Just for this moment, okay? Period. Now I know, though. I'm not going to, like, fast, but I do know I need to eat salads leading up to Summerfest. Now that I know what the deal is, I'm going to be prepared next time. You know
Especially
what I mean?
Especially now that we got the plug at Cousins.
Exactly. Shout out to Cousins.
Across from the Miller Lite Oasis stage.
I love it.
Got the plug.
Come on now. Make sure you go try that Cheetos Flamin' Hot Cheesesteak Sub. Tori Lowe is right here, like, chowing
Munching
down.
It down. Munching
chowing
it down.
Down. Look at him. Tori, you are hilarious. I can't. I love it. Hey, Ben, we're not trying to make you jealous, but I'm telling you right now.
I ain't gonna lie. Hidden. I'm over here getting a little hungry. All right, y'all talking about
that. Hey, man,
I know you can see the egg. Got the cheese curd.
Mel over there talking about the limeade, cherry limeade. I'm like, I need to get my black ass to Summerfest. Okay, I need to get down there and see what's going on.
Ben, and you know what? This shake is really good. Like, you, first off, you're funny for playing milkshake, and it was so fitting. No, you're funny for that, for real, but it was fitting because this milkshake will bring some boys to the yard, okay? I'm going to tell you that much right now.
It's going to bring me to the yard. All right, I'm coming down there to Summerfest, all right? I ain't going to stay trapped in this producer booth much longer.
No. Come on now. Let him out the booth. You hear me, Kyle? Let him out the booth.
Let me out the booth so I can speak the truth.
Hey, 12:56:50, Ben. As soon as you press that button, you can dip. 12:56:50.
We got five minutes for Ben jamming touchdown and let y'all know how amazing Summerfest is about to be.
Do we still need to take another break?
Or
we
no, still? This, no is this is it. This is the last one, dog.
This is it. All right, well, go ahead with it now. So what's been going on in pop culture, Mel? You was talking about the submarine. What has been going on in pop culture? Because listen, America, y'all wrong, okay? all these memes that got me feeling devilish and laughing at.
Oh, that.
But in summer, I feel terrible because y'all is terrible for making memes.
I can't look at them
anymore. There are people who potentially could be dying, and people are making memes, and unfortunately, some of them are funny.
The Simpsons
can we just?
But it's terrible. Like, as humans, what are we doing? These are real humans.
And first off, Kyle, I'm going to tell y'all this much because I sent Kyle and Ben a bunch of articles. I haven't been able to stop reading about this. I think a big reason why people feel like they can poke fun is because all of these individuals, minus the 19-year-old, I don't know if he fully understood what he was getting himself into, but all of these individuals, they literally signed waivers where on the first page alone, there are three different parts that say, you may die from this. Like, they knew full well that they were literally putting their lives at risk. And one of the articles that I read, y'all, was so intriguing because it was saying there's this odd fascination right now with the elite, with the 1%, where they spend all their money on, you know, space travel and all these things and doing stuff that, you know, the average citizen can't do. And now they're spending their money to put their lives at risk. And they're like, it's just such an interesting phenomenon that we're, you know, experiencing right now. And I agree. And I think, going back to my original point, Kyle, I think that's why people feel like they can make fun, because it's like, y'all theoretically knew what you were getting yourselves into, but it's still really horrible. Like, how can you make fun of something like this?
No, Mel, I 100% agree with you. That is the exact reason why, because they're billionaires, they're rich, wealthy people who put their lives on the line, but they live this way. Like, they like to be adventurous. They have access to things that we don't.
Correct.
So, as I know, me, you, and Ben were talking about it yesterday, this is one of many things that they do that's quite adventurous and dangerous.
Yep.
And, you know, you only can, you know, Cass has 9 lives, and, you know, it might be one of them situations where, unfortunately, they may not make it alive, but you are absolutely right. It's the fact that it seemed like something that seems so dangerous to us normal people.
Right.
But when you risk your life and do crazy things like this before,
right,
you sometimes forget that you are human.
And correct.
Life can end at any moment.
Well, and I just don't appreciate the fact that the 19-year-old, that's the one that really is bothering me. So that family, they are one of the wealthiest families in Pakistan. And so they're very well known there. 19-year-olds, your brains are not fully formed. So his father obviously is the one that should be protecting him and maybe ensuring that he is not put in those kind of situations. And I understand, listen, y'all, I'd like to think none of them were like, yeah, we're probably gonna die. Like, I'd like to think none of them were thinking that way. I just don't appreciate the fact that he brought his son along for the ride. Like, that's what's really bothering me.
Yeah, you know, again, I don't know billionaire lives, so I guess I got to stay in my tax bracket and my pay.
But you can still have a comment.
I can't judge what the father decided to do with the son. He
I
is a grown
you.
Man. Made
I hear
decisions,
you.
But I'm with you. You still, as a parent, you would think you always are thinking about the well-being of your child. And knowing that there was some risk to it. Because
exactly.
I think they successfully did this trip less than 5 times.
Correct.
And so it just seems way too dangerous. Ben, you had a comment?
Yeah, no, I did want to say something because more news has came out about this submersible submarine or whatever. But ultimately, they just found debris of the submersible. And again, for people who don't know, they were supposed to take a two hour trip down to go see the Titanic. Unfortunately, they only made it down or lost connection at an hour and a half in. And mind you, they just found debris of the submersible vehicle, so more than likely they never even made it down there to the
Titanic ship.
Titanic at all. So
down that ditch.
Well, in that, Ben, believe it or not, though, I know you say it's unfortunate, and it is, but that actually is the best possible scenario besides rescue. Because I read a lot about this, Ben. Even if they had found it, how would they have brought them up?
Correct.
You know what I mean?
That's
like,
true.
There's so many more layers to this. And if they had found it, that means that they're down there essentially waiting to die.
No,
so
that
was instant.
Yeah.
But hopefully it was an instant, like, they don't know what happened. You know what I'm saying?
You would much rather prefer that instant death than
correct.
The long,
correct.
Drag
slow. Correct. So,
ending.
I am
so praying
that that's
we
what
are.
That means.
We
you
absolutely
know?
Are praying for the family.
Yeah, of course.
Don't go to Blink-182 concerts.
Oh, my gosh. The stepson. Ben, we got to talk about the stepson tomorrow. You know that, right? We have to talk about that.
He waiting on the wheel.
It's too soon, Ben. Hey, Tory Lowe is up next from 1 to 4. We're going to let him finish these cheese curds, and then he's going to broadcast live from Summerfest and take over these airwaves. Ben, appreciate you in the booth. We'll see you down here shortly. Kyle, appreciate you.
Thank you, Mel, for inviting me.
Hey, thanks for being here. We'll see y'all tomorrow, God willing. Have a good rest of your day.
Summerfest is back, and the new 101.7 The Truth has got you covered with front row access wristbands to your favorite shows. Tune in to Truth in the Afternoon all week long as I will be giving away a pair of wristbands and general admission tickets to see Earth, Wind & Fire on Friday, June 30th. Make sure You're tuned in to 101.7 The Truth from 4 to 6 p.m., so you don't miss your chance to see them up close and personal during Milwaukee's biggest summer party. Summerfest is presented by our founding partner, American Family Insurance.
June is National Home Ownership Month, where we promote the benefits of home ownership and recommit to creating opportunities for future homeowners. Tune into 101.7 The Truth all month long, where you will get information and resources and hear interviews promoting home ownership in our community. At the core mission of National Home Ownership Month is the belief that every person deserves the chance to live with security, dignity, and hope in a place that they can call home. National Home Ownership Month on 101.7 The Truth is presented by Axe Housing and BMO Harris Bank.
On the Rocks, premium cocktails are now being served at 720. Located in downtown Milwaukee at 720 North Milwaukee Street, join them Saturday, June 24th, for the chance to enjoy these premium cocktails on them. Try their Effin' Cosmopolitan, Hornitos Margarita, and Knob Creek Old Fashioned. You can also purchase these products locally at Diamonds Beer and Liquor. Please drink responsibly. On the Rocks, ready to serve cocktails.
The Age of Reason took place over 200 years ago. It was a time of amazing scientific and philosophical progress all over the world. Truth, reason, and tolerance thrived and even shaped the Constitution of the United States of America, the foundation of our democracy. But now those building blocks of America, of democracy,